sitting up, man. I'm trying to do that moonshot.
Stop me from being able to move my words. Tangle them up.
In a triangle, Jaimie, triangle.
You gotta know it's coming. Yeah. He's gonna know it's coming.
He's sitting here trying to bait me and throwing one of those.
I mean, just kidding. Not today.
I was like, damn, I can lift him up under. Wrist lock.
The first one I didn't even need to do. I was trying to reach up my leg up there to start pushing you that way to go for an arm bar and you just scooped it.
You like that wrist lock?
I don't like it.
It's off that gift wrap.
Hey, that wrist lock. It's like wrist locks are confusing because you're kind of not aware of the coming because you think about something. Or you might think you have a good position and buy it.
Yeah.
Same thing with a toe hold too.
That's how he got me with the one from the arm triangle. I planted my hand because I was like, oh, perfect. Now he's not going to be able to get my arm across.
There's always something else, man.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay with that?
Yeah. It's just sore from the use of the arm. Who wants?
Who's next?
I'm going to sit out because I'm going to come back and do it for another class.
Okay.
You got 10 minutes?
Okay. Alright, let's try.
No, did you do 10 minutes?
Oh, yeah, 10 minutes.
Alright. Alright, let's go. Yeah, you moved it.
Yep.
Yeah, it's over the board. Thank you.
I push that leg in. It's my only good leg.
That's that one, right?
Okay.
I'll try to scissor you this way.
No, thank
you. So I have a challenge that I don't want to do
my eyes like this.
I don't want to see it. Yeah.
That's a bad ankle, right?
Yeah, it's okay. Don't worry.
And I go back like this and I go like this.
That's all I
do. You want to switch? You want to go back to my part?
Yeah.
You
want
to
go
back to my part? Yeah.
It was a good setup though. You did well. Your back is safe.
House
I was like, wait a minute, is this? Yeah, it is.
I
I want to do this.
That one right here?
I want to go like this.
Yeah.
But you wouldn't let me. So I was like, angle like that.
Two things I can do. I can sneak out this way,
so now
I have the underhook,
we'll come back in.
Or I can just back that push if you're on no gi.
Okay.
If I can go here, this is much better. But this is fine. I'm going to just push, keep this pulled, and roll.
Before you even turn. But turning
it, it's even easier.
It makes it
easier. Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
you got to that position twice. First time, you did the sweep.
Yeah,
like it's hard.
This time,
second time, I was trying to work out to your back.
Yeah, so I had to pace myself.
And I was trying to, there's some of those element handscapes where he works between getting to half guard and getting the leg.
Well, I mean, yeah, there's a lot of landing tricks in half guard.
Yeah.
Really is.
And it's like a, so when he's there and he has the underhooks, he's basically trying to see if he can grab the leg in, and if they don't fight it, he goes into half guard and goes forward. But it's something like if they fight it and try to run away, he goes straight into the leg out.
Which
I need to remember how to do.
The red guard is far, it hurts your back.
Gordon Ryan.
Because the range of motion is longer. So what you can do, if you can't get the half guard, put like a,
have you ever been blocked?
So it's showing the ground motion.
Yeah. He does a lot
of block tail up. The ones that can
handle
the jump, the rubber or even snag them. So you can do that since it shows the range of motion.
He does.
That bar is a little higher. It's very dense bar, like where the plate is like this high.
Yeah.
He likes to sweep from it and somehow come up in the
trap bar is a little higher.
Yeah.
So you're gonna have to put velocity on this time.
Which actually the first thing I really got down on this was the knee on belly series.
Squats, barbell squat.
Like the day I bought it or the week I bought it, I started with Patrick.
Of course.
And I was like, oh, it's got a whole section on that? That's first.
Okay. That helps with your stimulating the leg right now.
Yeah. I haven't been really hitting well yet. So, I got knee on belly. Obviously, this would be up. You'd have
to exercise. So, pressure core exercise? Yeah. Squat, that's why you bench press all that? It's not necessary.
This way, it's block the knee, keeping my elbow tight so you can't dive.
Oh, if you're going to do chest, dumbbell would be better.
But as I turn,
because you know what falls in form? That's your body form, where the barbell can force you to use that straight bar.
Yeah. Knee bar? Or if I can get my football weight.
So that's all I've been doing this whole time, you know what I mean?
Oh, really? Yeah. Come back.
It's been about a year, year and 1 month
your
now.
Knee a little lower.
We started initially.
Because what I need to do
and we work
is actually get my foot right here.
Right here.
And turn it over. Sorry.
Then
I'll. But you can do each one, knee bar four.
Yeah.
People that I could say, actually. I've been trying to work out
in some last practice. Jiu-Jitsu, MMA, whatever, they use the trap bar.
Yeah.
Because the bar, the straight bar.
When you're on belly, you go cross slide, and this piece in the butt.
Yeah.
And you reach, you scoop, you post on this leg, but then you kick them forward and wave
shield
this
way. It's more taxing your lower back.
And scoop under the leg.
Because when you use the trap bar, it's higher. If you use your quads, your butt.
Actually, there's the
grip strength and all.
I asked if it was Brandon, the guy who used to teach you. There's a black belt Brandon that was part of it.
So when your lower back is tired, it'll affect like.
And I got that. I got the escape from him and got to where I was cupping his heel, but he ripped his heel out. There was no way I was keeping that and keeping my arm.
No, Brandon, thank you so much. He doesn't train anymore.
Can I do like a 10 minute on the bottom and then I just switch 5 minutes or a couple minutes between each of you guys? Like maybe 2 or 3 minutes per person, like a jump thing?
Where's that list for the 10 minutes?
Is it 10 minute rolls?
I think it's up there,
I think you can do a lot better. Even though blue belt's harder, I think you'll do better.
I think so.
Yeah. Because the white belt is just a bunch of guys that can be doing it for 3 to 4 years. So probably blue belt in there. Where you go to blue belt now, you guys all know like y'all been training for at least a certain amount of time.
Yeah.
Right? And you know more too. How should we do this? 5 minutes per person or? I don't know. It's like whatever you guys want to do.
Down for whatever.
Okay.
I feel like blue belt will be less winning by just sheer aggression. And I know the rules a little better.
Yeah.
So no more giving up points for ankle locks when I don't need to.
Today, today is the 6th,
right?
Today is the
6th. Move it away. Do to me now. Hey.
Two, 4-2 now.
You got two another one?
Angle pick.
Okay.
One minute till the switch.
This is a very good row, Jaimie. 4-4.
Thank you.
You know, it's like washing my legs and stuff.
Yeah. I thought I had that other set.
Nah.
Anymore.
I was ready for it. Thank you.
This was your idea.
I don't know.
Got 30 seconds, a little under.
Yeah, yeah, right here.
I had my arm.
If he kept it going, I'm trying to tap for the jaw, man.
I had my arm on the neck, but like your arm from the gift wrap, so I could put it on your jaw.
Yeah. About the only thing I can do, just try to buy time, just try to go up higher. Yeah. Man, it was on the jaw. Like at a tournament, I tapped. And it hurt.
Well, I wouldn't. At a tournament, I wouldn't tap. It was on the jaw.
Yeah,
I would. Here I would. I wouldn't tap.
I want to go up the jaw.
Well, I mean, nobody does. I feel like on jaw pressure, man, as long as I keep my mouth closed, I can incrementally turn my chin and alleviate some pressure.
Yeah.
There's nothing against jaw.
But as soon as your jaw is open, it's kind of a similar thing, like, you know, when you're doing frames, right? If you do a frame and your elbows are bent, it's easy for them to collapse your arms all the way. Versus if your elbows are locked out, it's very difficult. I think it's the same with your jaw. If your jaw is closed, it's really difficult to, you know, open it. But if it's open and pressure open, it's very difficult for you to reclose it. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does make sense.
Kind of doubt.
Yeah, when it's like this,
or yeah, I can close then, it. Like if I have pressure like that, and my jaw is open,
yeah.
Oh yeah, I'm tired.
Yeah.
Because it'll dislocate, it'll snap, whatever. But if my jaw is shut, and they have pressure, I feel like, you know, don't get me wrong, there are some, like, yeah, it's just too much, but
yeah,
for the most part, I feel like I can kind of wiggle my head a little bit and alleviate some of that pressure.
Do you guys write down all your 10 minutes?
Not yet.
Yeah. I know mine, but I don't know who did who.
I got 10 with both of you guys.
I got 10 with Syed and Robert.
I got 10 Robert, I got 10 with Syed, and I got 10.
Just, yeah. I'll do another one if you guys are down. I'll be down for the 10 minutes.
Okay. Hey, after this, let's we play okay with each other and then take down and stuff. I want to like
just, okay,
yeah, about muscle memory. Okay, round is on.
Okay, I set
that. Hey, Jimmy, bro. This is like crazy. Today we like a lot of like rolling.
Look, Jamie trying to intimidate me with his height.
Yeah. Jamie, rubber guard.
You guys each had a 10-minute together, right?
Yeah, I did 10 with Jaimie and 10 with you.
Okay.
Jaimie did 10 with me and 10 with Syed.